N-O, an artist and designer. This is Roseanne Floresca, manager and specializes in mathematics. Maricourt Magat, literary and spatial director. Christy Mills, who does each individual room.
This is to construct a learning environment that will suit students, staff, and administration needs. First, we'll show you our site plan. We have no intention on ruining any of the nature space because we find that a very important factor in our school. It helps a lot for students to be able to see like nature. We don't want to see cities outside of our school. We want to see nature. That helps the mind. And so what we did is we plan to preserve it. And the buildings are placed on the flat surface that was provided in a close area because we wanted to make it convenient for students to travel to each building. They're connected by walkways. There's a walkway in between the two domes, and then here's the gym. The gymnasium is a separate area that is located to the left of the domes, and to the right of the domes is the baseball field. The gymnasium consists of three levels, which pertains to an underground parking lot, which will provide a convenient way of traffic, because we don't want traffic outside of the school, which can be like a drag. So we had the underground parking lot, which is next to the road, of course, because we don't want them driving through areas that they can't drive through. On top, there's two top levels. On top of the gym is a field. We made this field, it's kind of unique. The field is the top level, which is outdoor, but it's built to be, well, it's just like a regular field, but it's on top of a building with artificial grass, etc. What we did is we provided the school with a bridge that goes over the river so that students may, in any way for lunch or for studying, may go onto the hill where provided benches are. And they also have the courtyard provided where they can be outside for any reasons. The cost of our school was quite pricey. I would have to say it's really high. The cost is approximately about 500 million. The reasons, we have reasoning for this, and the domes have two levels. Domes are very spacious, you know, and with two levels, that's a lot of floor space, including the gym and the making of the baseball field. But in reasoning later, that will explain that the cost of the school is very high, but it's very efficient when it comes to energy saving. And so you may be paying a lot at the beginning, but throughout the years, you'll be saving. Yeah.
Okay, we wanted to bring uniqueness to our school, and so we chose the geodesic building structure for the two main buildings. And here are some pictures that we got our inspiration from. And right here is just the outside structural form, an interior picture and an exterior picture. And domes provide like a free span self-supporting structure requiring no interior support. They're stronger and safer buildings which are proven to withstand natural disasters such as earthquakes, tornadoes, storms, all that. They use a third less materials than rectangular buildings, which means low maintenance.
We have two entrances and exits at the front of the class. Right here would be windows, so the kids can see out into the open area. There'd be two students per a desk, and we figured that allows individual learning and group learning in pairs. And if the students are working on a big project, they can go to we have an area in the middle of one of our domes that is just an open area just for group work that students are allowed to go to.
And for solar power, solar panels incorporate both types of energy, which includes passive and active. Passive being just like the direct sunlight from windows, and active being collective energy. And the solar panels will be used on the roofs of buildings. As of Cal-Law, it's the most insulating diffuse light transmitting sandwich panel in the world. It is formed by permanently bonding under heat and pressure using special formulated fiberglass. It provides glare-free, shadowless light as well as thermal heating, and it will form the exterior interior walls of our buildings. And these forms of energies, they're like fit for our school because of the comfortable learning environment they provide. And as well, for the colder part of the year, winter and fall, electricity will then be used for backup if needed.
These domes, what is their diameter?
For the smaller, for the lower levels, the radius is 140, so 280. Is the diameter for the smaller ones is 280, and the diameter for the bigger domes, the upper level, but the higher level is 400.
Okay, so, and the height of the dome in the center? It'd be the same as the radius, right? So
yeah.
It'd be 140 feet tall.
Right.
So there's a lot of space in here. Have you thought about how that space could be used?
For the lower levels, they're mainly offices and libraries where students can get easy access to office attendance and everything. And for the upper levels are food areas for studying. Also, it's not just a food area, and for learning, mostly learning space, where they can go from their classes into an area where they can get together with bigger groups.
If you were to draw a section of the dome, how many layers would there be, or floors would there be in there?
Two.
Okay, I didn't get that early on. So I gather that this idea is that the surrounding perimeter of the dome would be rooms, the classrooms?
Right. The classrooms would be somewhat shapes of trapezoids. When you take a geodesic dome, they would most likely form a circle. I mean, there are a lot of triangles and hexagons forming a building, but the base would most likely come to in a circle. And the rooms would be 44 feet by 40 in length, and then 34 feet. Yeah, they'd be around the building. And then the inner part is the other space area.
And you talked about how the classroom itself would have, if I understand this right, glazing glass on this end. And is that end of the classroom on the curve, the outer edge?
Yeah, this part right here is kind of an extended area that comes out of the geodesic dome, for instance, right here that you can see. It's like kind of like a pushed out part of the building. And then the pushed in part is a long extended wall where there's basically windows. And so that's a window per class. It's like, so yeah, the exterior would be windows besides the extended part.
Okay, so on your dome, it has on the first two levels a lot of glass around the perimeter. And then what's the top of the dome like?
The top, well, the very top is solar panels, which are transparent.
Okay.
And the second level is windows also. But because of the curviness of the building, the windows are kind of at a slant. And the windows will have to be designed in a way that they kind of work with the curviness of the building.
Okay.
There's a drawing right there. That's the gymnasium?
Yeah, this is the gym. This is the underground parking. And then this would be boys and girls locker rooms. And this is our basketball court that lifts up and retracts back with a pool underneath.
Ah, that's pretty nice.
We took an idea from an old-fashioned movie, which is A Wonderful Life, if you've seen that movie. It was an old idea and we just brought it back.
Okay, if you were to characterize this school, is it teacher-based learning or is it learner-based learning?
It's more, I don't really know how to describe it.
I would have to say it's basically a mixture because we want students to be able to learn on their own, which is why we provided them with technology as laptops. But we also want them to have that one-on-one student-teacher relationship. So we don't want to deprive them from having a teacher because, you know, there's different students in different schools and, you know, some people learn differently. And so we want to make sure they have both ways of learning.
Thank you.